a doll's house. Who's the writer? Barbie?
No, Raggedy Ann. It was written by Henrik Ibsen.
So you mean he has time to host Good Morning America and still write children's plays?
No, that's Charlie Gibson. A Doll's House is a classic play about a woman who feels trapped by her conventional life.
So which role are you going for?
Obviously the most challenging.
You mean the one with the most lines?
Exactly. I need to have as many lead roles as I can possibly land in order to make it to Broadway.
Ah, New York. That's my dream, too. Sleep on a park bench, playing little coffee houses.
You guys, I have to get this part. I must draw upon my method acting skills and become a depressed Swedish housewife so I can get to Broadway. The only problem is I don't know how to get depressed.
Try your mother's a recovering alcoholic, and your father insists that you call his teenage fiancé Mom.
Ernest, maybe you ought to give up rock and roll and sing some country.
Mama's having a hard time giving up the Jim Beam. And my daddy, he's marrying the homecoming queen.
Sometimes in this life, you can feel all by yourself.
Check, one, two.
But I have a partner, but I can't trust no one else.
So don't isolate yourself when there's nobody around.
Oh, yeah.
I'll be there.
Hip-hop hooray for the Flex Files. Ex-jock and blonde bombshell are a winning combo.
The chemistry between Flex Washington and Holly Spears is a breath of fresh air. Scratch and sniff me, Geraldine, because I stink of success.
Well, pull my finger, because our general manager, Johnny Bullbank, is meeting with Queen's World Syndication.
Johnny Bullbank smells me, too?
Uh-huh. Yeah, and you know what that means. Looks like we're finally going national.
Ooh, national?
Yes.
The Flex Files going nationwide?
Mm-hmm.
I'll need new suits, new shoes, a new sign-off. Something that says America. Flamerica.
Slow down, big boy, okay? It's not all about you. The critics are loving the whole Denzel Washington meets Pamela Anderson thing. They're loving the swirl.
Hey, the last time I checked, only the chocolate in that swirl was nominated for Baltimore's Best Sports Anchor. She's just a peroxide monkey on my back.
Yeah, well, you give that monkey a banana and keep her happy because she's our ticket to syndication. Oh, here comes Monkey Brewster now.
Why are you so happy? Did the one-thumb security guard ask you out on a date again?
No, I have a new Liebchen. Liebchen is German for sweetheart, and I have one. Helmut Rose. He's a German history professor, and he's almost as smart and pretty as I am.
Holly, you're so self-centered. There are more important things to talk about. Me. Now, I'm inches away from going national, and I've decided to take you along with me.
You know, I've been giving this a lot of thought. And should I change my name to Holly Rose or Holly Spears Rose?
Look, how am I ever going to become Nora if I can't get sad?
Okay, here's one. When I was 5, my dad ran over my favorite doll and wouldn't replace it.
You had a doll?
Action figure. I meant action figure.
My parents always taught me to look on the bright side. Being positive is stifling my creativity.
I know, me too. Look at this shirt.
What? It's really cute.
You don't break into the fashion world by being cute. You break in by being ugly and loud.
But why don't you just scream?
Wait, where are you going? My audition is in 2 days. I need help. Depress me.
Well, picture yourself at a crossroads that you don't know which way to turn, but you don't want to turn back.
Alone at a crossroads.
Shut up, spirit. Mr. Washington?
Boy. Hey, guess what? Looks like my show is definitely going nationwide.
Oh, Daddy, that's great. We need to celebrate. great.
Oh, I can't tonight. I'm having dinner with Geraldine to talk strategy.
But, Daddy, you're always working. I'm your daughter. You're supposed to make time for me.
Okay, how about this? I have a nominee's dinner coming up in a couple of days. How about you be my date?
Really, Daddy, you mean it?
Yeah, why not? I have the prettiest date there, and I'll even buy you a new dress.
Captain Flamerica.
Hey, buddy, can I get my power tie back that you borrowed?
Yeah, about the tie, I'm actually wearing it right now. As a garter. Yeah, I use it to woo Candy into moving in with me. And she agreed.
Congratulations, man. You two thinking about getting married?
Oh, marriage? No, not yet. Just roommates. Mm-hmm. Roommates who spoon. And a fork. And a spatula.
I get the picture. Wow, Candy moving in, that's a big step. You never lived with a woman before.
Nope. Well, other than my mama. And my canary Fifi, who actually turned out to be a boy. Do you know how hard it is to find out the sex of a bird? Another time.
Man, let me tell you how it is when your girlfriend moves in. First, it's beautiful. All the loving and cuddling.
Ooh, I like that part.
And then she starts cooking your favorite things, helping you with housework, and she starts laughing when she falls in the toilet because you forgot to put the toilet seat down.
Yeah. I do that sometimes. Yeah.
And then they turn on.
Huh?
Yeah. The loving and the cuddling is replaced with a swat. And a smirk. The house cleaning stops and is replaced with a, boy, pick up your socks. Would you think I'm a maid?
And the toilet seat thing?
Ooh, once you hit a splash, that's 2 weeks on the couch. Alone. No spoon. No fork. No spatula. That's it for the Flex Files. I'm Flex Washington, and that's my meal ticket. Flat out. Oh, what are you, a clown in Barnum and Bimbo?
He left me, Flex.
Who, Liebchen?
He said I was too loquacious, too malleable, too necessitous.
Too wordy?
Maybe I was too clingy, or I wasn't smart enough, or I'm too fat.
Man, who knows what we're thinking? Buck up.
Okay, Flex, our syndication ship is sinking, so you need to board the good ship Holly Pop and make her happy.
Go, go, go. Maybe Helmut didn't think I was pretty enough.
Pretty enough? You? You're beautiful.
Oh, don't look now.
He dumped me, Flex. Like he's ashamed of me. He's the Democratic Party, and I'm Howard Dean.
Wow, that guy really hurt you, huh? You know what? Forget Helmut. He doesn't deserve you. You know what? Wash your face, and why don't you let me take you to lunch?
You want to have lunch with me? Wait, I thought you hate me.
Oh, how can I hate you? I mean, you're my sidekick. My dog. My show dog.
Show dog. I like that.
This was a good idea, Flex. I feel better already. It might have something to do with the fact that I haven't had carbs in 3 years. I want to marry the man who invented bread.
Helmut just walked in with a girl.
Helmut is a player. She is hot.
Flex, show dog hurting over here.
Hey, I'm sorry.
He can't see me alone, Flex. Grope me.
Oh. Holly?
Oh, hello, Helmut. Flex, Helmut, Helmut, Flex. He's my new Liebchen.
Oh, yeah, I'm Holly's new Liebchen. Or as we say in the hood, Le Boo.
I'm glad to see you've recovered from our brief love affair so quickly.
Actually, I'd like to thank you. If it hadn't been for your brief love, I never would have realized that my true love sits at the anchor desk with me daily.
Poor, poor rebounding Holly. A word of advice, Felix.
That's Flex, sauerkraut.
Girls like Holly, they are like Rubik's cubes. Hmm? At first, you can't put them down. But then they get all twisted, and they lose their novelty, yeah?
So that's all that was to you? Something you play with until you move on to your next plastic toy?
Helmet, you're an idiot. You let go of this beautiful woman for that. Shame on you. Holly is a wonderful, loving, caring, kind, and sexy woman. And it's the best thing that's ever happened to me.
Do you mean that, Flex?
Do I mean it?
Come, my schnitzel. I've lost my appetite.
Now that's a liebchen.
Geraldine, it's not what you think. Holly's ex came in here with his new bimbo, and we were just trying to make him jealous.
Flex was my knight in shining armor. He swooped in and saved the day.
You jumped in my lap.
Yeah, but you put your hands on my thighs like you meant it. Oh. That's the sweetest thing, Geraldine. Blah, 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 blah. What I see here is an opportunity, okay? A blonde bombshell and a chocolate wonder together on camera and off. Baltimore's gonna love it. Or they're gonna hate it. Either way, it's ratings bonanza.
Geraldine, how long are you suggesting we keep up this facade?
Just Flex, this is the hook we need to slam dunk the show into syndication. It's hip, it's splashy, it's funky fresh.
I appreciate the fact that you got yourself a hip-hop dictionary, but I'm not gonna do it. In other words, your idea is wiki-wiki-wack.
Hey, Daddy, I just want to thank you so much for these dresses. So which one should I wear to the dinner, this one or this one?
Brianna, sit down, baby.
What, you don't like these? You could buy me some more.
No, look, that was Geraldine. She sees this dinner as a promotional opportunity, and she's insisting that I take Holly as my date.
So you'd rather spend time with your fake girlfriend than your real daughter?
Brianna, baby, I'm sorry. I will make it up to you, I promise. I gotta go shoot some promos. I'm sorry.
Mr. Washington?
Boy.
Well, if you're here to tell me some more stories about your family to depress me, I'm good.
No, this is about me. I'm moving to New York.
You're right, and how you gonna get there? A tornado and a house with no foundation?
No, I'm serious. My mom's having a hard time with sobriety, and she wants us to move in with my aunt. If I'm gonna move, I'm going to New York to help my music. If I can make it there, I can make it anywhere. Ooh, I should write that down.
Wait a minute, this is for real? You're moving to New York? When? What about school? What about senior year?
Well, there are schools in New York. Besides, there's nothing here for me.
Nothing? Nothing at all?
Look, Brianna, this isn't about you. Okay, this is about me and what I need to do.
Fine. Then go.
Look, Brianna, don't be mad. Okay, it's gonna take me a few days to raise the money, and besides, it's not like I'm leaving today.
Watch the Flex Files on WYNX and learn something new about sports every time.
Lesson number one. And cut! Hoochie Wally, it's getting hot in her.
All right, this is going too far. And Holly, I believe this is your gum.
Nothing wrong with using my feminine wiles to appeal to the sophomoric sensibilities of our core audience.
Oh, you can't see my bra.
Look, I want to talk about the nominee's dinner. I've tipped off the press about your torrid love affair, so I want you two to really couple it up for the cameras, okay? Holly, what are you wearing?
You should wear that dress you wore at the Christmas party last year.
Wear something twice, Flex? I don't double dip. But I am flattered you remembered.
You know what? Why don't you wear something red? Red brings out the sparkle in your eyes.
Okay. I'll wear red because I'm your good show dog. You barking like a couple of lovebirds. Guess who's coming to dinner?
Okay, I'll go along with this as long as we all agree on two things. This whole thing is a fake, and I'm better looking than Sidney Poitier. They call me Mr. Washington.
Until they became my opinions.
I don't know my first line. What's my first line? How am I going to audition if I don't know my first line?
Why are you so freaked?
I don't know. It could be the fumes from that oil rag you're passing off as a t-shirt. It's hideous.
Thanks.
It's my new line, Oil Rag by Spirit.
Oh, my God, I think I'm next. Oh, I'm gonna tank. I can't believe Arnez will tell me that he's leaving for New York right before the biggest audition of my life.
Rihanna, you can't fault Arnez. We're all just chasing our dreams. Now, you need to focus on this audition and make Debbie Gibson proud. Henrik Ibsen.
Rihanna Barnes, you're next.
Oh, my God, that's me. How am I gonna do this? This play's about a woman who's lonely and desperate, who feels unloved, who feels that her father and her husband always put their needs before hers. How can I relate to that? Oh. You've never understood me. I've been dreadfully wrong, Torvald. First by Papa and then by you. You never loved me. You only found it pleasant to be in love with me.
Wow, everyone's staring at us.
I know, it's like we're an exhibit at a talent museum.
Okay, doing good, Flex.
Now have her come sit on your lap.
Hey, Hallie, come sit on my lap. Let's give him the money shot.
Good, good. Now give her a little kiss on the cheek.
Ooh, that's nice, Flex.
Good, good. Now feed her a breadstick. No, not that one, the long one.
I'll be back. Give me 1 minute. Okay, this is not gonna work. I think I know how to bring a freak out in a woman.
I don't think you do. Not a freak like Holly. So you just need to put this back in your ear and let me walk you through it.
Do you know who I am? These streets are littered with my conquest. You've never driven down Flex X Boulevard. It is quite a ride. So buckle up, baby.
So can anyone park there or do I need a permit?
All right, now where were we?
Wow.
I know. All right, guys, I think you got enough shots. Give us some privacy. Man, people are really starting to eat this me and you thing up.
It's delicious, isn't it?
Ooh! Okay, the cameras are gone. I don't think your foot is supposed to be there. Or there!
It's okay, Flex. You wouldn't have gone through all this trouble if you didn't feel the way you feel or kissed me the way you kissed me.
Oh! You got a hole in your stocking.
See? You notice everything about me. That's why it's obvious.
What's obvious?
You're falling in love with me. And I feel the same way.
Huh?
See, now this is the kind of place that Candy's gonna want to come home to.
Mm-hmm.
She hasn't always had it easy, you know. She grew up in different foster homes and never had a strong male role model in her life. I hope I can be that for her.
Duane, you can talk all you want, but I'm not gonna forget that she owed me $20.
Rats. Hello?
Oh, hey, Sal.
Oh, Bermuda, fun, yeah. Hey, do you need me to open up the car lot tomorrow? What do you mean there's no car lot? What do you mean there's no tomorrow? Okay. Well, it was nice knowing you too, Sal. Oh, I'm sorry. Adios, Juan Tito.
Well, that's your boss?
Well, not anymore.
Juantito, formerly known as Big Sal, formerly known as Jimmy the Snitch, is being investigated for tax evasion and he's closing down the car lot. Man, I'm out of a job.
Oh, Dwayne, I'm sorry.
Man, what am I gonna tell Candy? She's expecting to move in with a responsible, stable, employed man.
Dwayne, your Candy's home.
November and we're sitting out on the beach.
I love California. What?
Me too. I get a tan all year. In Des Moines, the only thing we did all year was wish we were somewhere else.
What a great way to kick off my 19th birthday. Back home in Baltimore, I'd be hiding all of this under a big winter coat.
The mystery's gone. The frustration is still there.
Sure beats going to class.
You say that like you go to class.
You say that like my mother.
That's a broken English and disappointment.
What? Look at her puppies.
She only had one dog, Arnett.
But it was a puppy, right?
Arnett, let's go. We got a game. Maybe a little later. Come on. A volleyball girl's just showing up, all right? All right. You can't disappoint our girls.
Girl.
Sometimes in the slide, you can feel all by yourself. I'll be fast and thick and thin. Why don't you love where you fall? Living one on one. In a body great to spawn. Living one on one. Now we're having fun.
Again, you know, it goes against the laws of physics.
What, women can't beat men?
No, women with breasts that big jumping that high, you know?
So, D-Mac, how do you know these hoes? I mean, young lady.
You play with them every week, except for Alexis, she's new. And I'm hoping to play with her all by myself.
Hey, D-Mac, you grab one for Alexis, too?
Oh, yeah, I get her water if she gives me her phone number.
She'll give it to you if you promise to give it to Arnett. All she talks about is wanting some of that. She's not the only one. We'd all like to spike that.
Brooke, have you met Arnett's girlfriend? You know, the one with the black belt and crazy?
Yes, hello, Brooke. So were you just babbling something about my man?
Hey, I don't need to tell you that he's fine. But if I were you, I would hold on tight. Later.
Now hold on tight to your throat.
No, look, no, that's not necessary, Brianna, for real. Women are always hitting on our nerves, but that's cool because when they find out he's taken, Cash and I are always there to pick up the pieces. Peace. Hey, hey!
Believe that, skank? Throwing herself at somebody else's man.
Get used to it. This is Hollywood. Greyhound rolls in a fresh batch of skanks daily.
You came here on a bus?
Oh, good one. But seriously, Brianna, I mean, look around us. There are hot women everywhere.
Whatever. I don't have anything to worry about. Arnaz knows how lucky he is. Especially since I'm going to surprise him with the gift that he's been waiting for.
Music lessons?
No, tomorrow night, for my 19th birthday, I've decided to take my walk into womanhood.
Whoa. Oh my gosh, you're gonna do it? How exciting.
Aw, your first time.
I remember my first time. Wait, that was my second. Maybe it was my third. Well, anyways, they were all special in their own way.
No, they're not. I may have only done it once, but it wasn't special at all. Don't worry, it gets better when you have a partner.
So, Brianna,
why now? I mean, you've obviously been waiting for a reason.
Well, I've waited because my parents hammered the fear of getting pregnant into my head. But now, Inez and I are grown, and we're ready.
Have you thought about what you're gonna use?
I'd suggest a bed, Brianna, and not the bed of a pickup.
I told you my first time was bad. I hate Oklahoma.
Okay, you know what? This is just too weird. I don't need any other options. Let's just go to the drugstore and buy some condoms or something. Come on.
Oh, wait. Relax, Brianna. We're already here, and the people in these places are really easy to talk to. So just smile and nod, and it'll be over before you know it.
Yeah, kind of like my first time.
Hi.
Ooh.
Sorry for the wait. It's been a crazy day. I just spilled salsa all over my shirt. Sorry. Thank you.
Thank you!
So, are we here for the free condoms, or do you ladies want the full rundown?
Oh, full rubdown, please. I mean, rundown.
Okay, so sex? Any first-timers?
Fine! I'm a virgin! Virgin, are you satisfied?
Being a virgin is not a stigma. It's a choice. But if you are considering sex, you should know that while the condom is the most popular choice, it's not 100% effective for preventing pregnancy or sexually transmitted diseases. There's nothing funny about STDs.
She said titties. Titties.
So in addition to the condom, you should really use something else, like a spermicide, a diaphragm, or a cervical cap. Let me demonstrate.
Pick me!
I thought I used this diagram of a uterus here.
What's that? Giggling! You're making this even more embarrassing than it already is.
Oh, he's so hot. I would drink his bathwater with a crazy straw. Hey. Oh my god. Do you think he heard that?
Yes, I did. Now, where I put that lubricant?
I'm sorry. I thought that was a free sample.
Well, if you follow these preventative steps, you'll be safe and your partner will be too. Any questions?
Yeah. Do you like Italian food?
Any questions about sex?
Well, you didn't let me finish.
Well, feel free to call if you have any more questions. Here's some free samples for you, and you. Be safe. Oh, sorry, no crazy straws.
He winked at me!
From Lisa and I for your big night. Happy birthday.
Aw, how sweet. Oh, we have black love incense. Oh, with strawberries and whipped cream. Oh, and I can't believe it's not body butter. Oh, thanks, guys.
Oh, I'm sorry. The body butter's mine. You're not ready for that. Now, come on, Lisa. Let's give Brianna her privacy.
Hey.
So, what you get me?
Actually, I wrote you a song. But your present is, I'm not gonna sing it. But I do have something for you to unwrap.
Okay, well, happy birthday to me.
Sorry, I didn't see anything. Just forgot my keys.
Okay, come in.
My God. You look beautiful.
So is this everything you've always wanted?
It's perfect. You're perfect. Someone's gonna die.
Wait, baby, I got this. Let me just finish unwrapping my present. This better be good, because I'm about to go Diary of a Mad Black Woman on y'all. Who is it?
Happy birthday!
It's my only daughter's 19th birthday. Aren't you surprised?
You have no idea. But a phone call would have been special, too.
Oh, nonsense. I knew y'all wouldn't be doing nothing. Our nerves is broke.
Rihanna, I'm about to explode. Well, joy now that your father's here. Hi, Mr. Washington.
Boy. Candles? Arnaz sweating like a runaway slave. Y'all ain't slick. I know what's going on here.
Oh, no, Daddy. It's not what you think. We're just, saving money. Yeah, that's why we got the candles lit and the air conditioner is off. You know, with Arnaz being so broke and all.
Oh, yeah, I'm broke. I'm so broke, I'm like temporary layoffs broke.
Oh, Dad, you should get to your hotel and check in before it's too late.
Yeah, you must be tired from your trip.
Are you kidding? I'm not going anywhere. It's my baby's birthday, and it only happens once a year.
Some of us not at all.
B-A-B-Y. Baby, as in they make you fat and it hurts when they come out.
All right, my turn. L E A V E. Leave. As in some people don't know when to. Enjoy those little things that fall off the trees.
Whoa, Mr. Washington, what a surprise. Look, everybody, it's Mr. Washington.
Hey, guy.
Hey. So, Arnaz, did you get a chance to go for your jog?
You know, the one you've been training for forever?
Yeah, you know, the one that you was gonna finish in record time.
Oh, that jog. No, that pain came back. You know, the one that comes and goes.
Hey, good night.
Night.
Good
night.
So, Arnaz. Jogging, are you?
Yeah, he's training for a marathon.
Well, I was, but it doesn't look like that pain is going anywhere. So I'm gonna just go to bed and massage it out.
Jesus pizza, huh?
Yep, and you cannot get this in Baltimore.
That's why I still live there, baby. You know, Brianna, it was pretty obvious what you and Arnaz were doing.
What, cheating at Scrabble?
No, before that. I just hope you were being safe. Nah, I would say safe and smart, but I've given up on smart since you're with Arnaz.
Don't worry, we plan on being safe.
Plan? You mean you haven't?
No, not yet. But Daddy, I do think we need to talk about this.
No, we don't. You said nothing happened, so I'm good. I was cool.
Look, Daddy, I can really use a male's perspective on this.
Okay, sure, we can talk about this when I'm dead and you're married. What? I'm not dead yet.
See, Daddy, that's my problem right there. Beautiful women like that are everywhere. It's a candy store here. And I was just afraid that if I didn't, you know, with Arnaz, that I would lose him.
Whoa. If you're thinking about doing you-know-what just to keep you-know-who, even though I don't know why, you're making a big mistake. That's the absolute wrong reason to do you-know-what with anybody.
Yeah, big surprise. My daddy doesn't want me to have sex.
Of course I don't, Brianna. What do you want me to say? Go ahead, have sex. It's great. Everybody's doing it. They'd revoke my daddy card.
Well, what if you weren't my daddy? What if I was a stranger? What would you say then?
I say, go away. I don't talk to strangers.
Daddy.
I would tell this stranger to make sure she knows everything about her partner's past. Ask as many questions as you can, even if it takes all night long, and hopefully kills the mood. Baby, once you go there, there's no turning back.
Thanks, Daddy.
You're welcome, stranger.
Arnaz! Hey, you're home! Arnaz is home! Yay!
Adios! Where are y'all going?
Oh, you know, we've got that thing we were talking about at that place.
Wait, you guys aren't trying to give us private time, are you?
What makes you say that?
I love you guys. Now get out.
No, oh, that was so nice of them.
Yeah, it was.
I am so thirsty. Do you want something?
Yes, but I'm having a hard time getting it. You haven't changed your mind again, have you?
No, of course not. I have dreamt of this for a long time. I just don't want to be thirsty when it happens.
Brianna.
Okay. I was ready to sleep with you, but I think I was doing it for the wrong reason.
There's no wrong reason, unless we're related. And even then, there's three states that we can move to.
I was afraid if I didn't sleep with you, I'd lose you. With all these beautiful women out here, I figured you'd get tired of waiting for me.
What? Don't you know that I love you and I'll wait forever if I have to? You're not gonna lose me.
I'm so confused.
Well, you know what they say? If you don't know what to do, have sex.
Don't blame me, they said it.
Look, baby, I want this to mean as much to you as it does to me. So, if you want to wait, I can wait.
Oh, I love you so much.
No, don't kiss me. Any contact can be very dangerous right now.
But maybe that's a risk I'm willing to take.
Are you serious?
Yes, but first, I think we should ask each other a few questions.
Sure, I'll go first. You want to have sex?
Now it's my turn. In the past 6 months, have you been diagnosed with any venereal diseases?
Come on, Brianna. You know the answer to that. Don't you want to ask me something that you don't know?
Okay. Are you going to lose interest in me after tonight?
Baby, of course not. I might fall asleep right afterwards, but that's just a normal guy thing. All right. Any more questions?
Yes. Just one more question. Can you wait 2 minutes while I put my nighty back on?
Girl. You got 30 seconds till liftoff. One, two, you better hurry up. Three, four.
Oh, you so bad.
Five, six. Don't worry about the door. I'll get rid of them. 15, 16. Mr. Washington.
You, me. We're going for a real job, boy.
Anas, where have you been?
I went jogging.
Oh, okay, a guy thing.
All right, you had to burn off some energy. That's cool. Because now you're all sweaty and I'm ready.
Remember our talk, boy. You touch her, I breaks your neck.
Daddy, what's wrong?
Sorry, baby, but I like my neck. Good night.
Coming at you from Westside Stadium with the little homies and the homettes of summer, this is Flex Washington, WYNX Sports, opening day of Little League Baseball. And I'm brushing its teeth, tucking it in, and putting this story to bed. Until next time, fly that! Oh.
What flew out of your mouth, a tic-tac or a tooth?
It was a tic-tac attached to a tooth.
Dad, you getting old. Your reflexes are gone.
There's nothing wrong with my...
Then quit.
You like that, right, shorty? All right, check this out. Steve Young to Jerry Rice.
I'm Keyshawn Johnson. Pass me the ball and buy my book.
Okay, go left, go left. All right, go right, go right, go right. All right, go deep, go deep, go deeper. While you by the fridge, grab me a Colt 45. No, I'm just kidding.
Man, you always messing with me. What you gonna do when I'm gone?
I'm gonna go back to leave my drawers on the floor.
Go back to? They've been there so long, I thought they were little area rugs.
You funny, ain't you? Look at you, my little boo-boo. I'm gonna miss you, man.
Me too. Dad, you ever think about moving from Baltimore to Atlanta so we can hang out like this all the time?
Yeah, I think about it a lot. I also think about your mother living there. Then I get over it. Hello? Oh, hey, Sandrella, how you doing, baby? Hold on. Sweetie, Daddy needs some privacy.
Brianna needs a 20.
Look, here's a dollar, and I'll write you a check for the rest.
I'm not taking one of your checks.
I know. I'm sorry we haven't had a chance to hook up. Yeah. But it's like I said, you know, when my daughter's in town, my pants aren't down.
And I'm behind your back, and all your pickup lines are whack. I got it.
Surprise!
Mom, what are you doing here?
Hey, baby. Uh-oh, Chandrella, I gotta go. It's my ex-wife. I guess Lucifer left the gate open.
I wish I had time to stay and hear your little Def Jam routine. I'm just here to pick up my daughter.
But, Mom, I had one more day with Dad.
I know, sweetie, but I wanted to surprise you and deliver this wonderful news I have in person. You got to sit down for this one.
Okay.
Baby, you remember when I applied for that PhD grant to study aquatic mammals and other marine life?
The one where you count whales?
Oh, that should be real easy for you. Weren't you raised by whales?
Anyway, I got the grant.
Yay!
We're going to Nova Scotia for a whole year. Yay! You ain't yan.
Well, Mom, when you first mentioned this, I looked Nova Scotia up online. And they ain't online.
You know what? There's an endangered species up there. What do you call them? Oh, yeah. Black people.
You know, Daddy's right. I should stay here with him.
Oh.
Which daddy said that?
Well, we just said how much we're gonna miss each other and that 2 weeks a year isn't enough.
Yeah, but daddy talk too much.
And you really want to stay here?
Mom, daddy and I are gonna be just fine.
Look, Nicole, you've done a really great job with her for 14 years. I can at least do it for one. It's my turn.
Okay. I'm not sure about this, but I'm a fair person. I'm willing to give it a try. Now, how about you and I get some dinner together?
Cool, let me get my jacket.
Okay, baby. All right, Flex, here's your chance to get out of it. Save a little face. I'll just tell Brianna that I changed my mind and she's coming with me. Because you and I both know you can't go 5 minutes between booty calls.
Okay, first of all, I can take care of my daughter. And second of all, you are wrong about that booty call thing. Hmm?
Hello, this is Flex. If you're ready to get freaky, press 1.
What happens when you press two?
Sometimes in this life, you can feel all by yourself.
Okay, one, two.
But I have a partner, but I can't trust no one else. So don't isolate yourself when there's nobody around.
Oh, yeah.
I'll be there.
Sweetie, look, we gotta talk. You stayed up till 3 in the morning playing Sega. Slept till noon, and I bet you didn't make your bed.
No, I didn't.
That's my girl.
Why make your bed?
When you just gonna get back in it.
Yeah. Man, I can't believe it's gonna be this much fun for a whole year.
That's right. No rules. Just fun, baby.
What's for breakfast? Oh, Snickers bar.
Yeah, just dip it in some applesauce to get your vitamin C.
Hello? Sure, operator. I'll accept the charges.
Is that Daryl Strawberry calling me from rehab?
No, it's an NFL player calling from prison.
Hang up.
Say it ain't so, dog. Say it ain't so. Say it.
Dwayne, what do you want, man? We gotta make this quick, because I got a live remote in an hour.
Hey, Dwayne.
Oh, hey, sweetie. Hey, that's my goddaughter. Man, I can't believe that little crumb snatcher is still here.
Then how did you hear about it?
Man, your dad came down to the used car lot complaining about an old truck that I sold him. Man, what part of as is does he not understand?
Well, you lucky he left your butt as is.
Man, what about you? Your ex-wife just comes, drops her off for a year. You're not even getting any. You must be whipped from the memory of it.
Now, hold on, man. You're supposed to be my boy. All right? I'm Flex Washington. I'm unwhippable.
All right, now.
All right? Although I don't mind being tied up sometimes.
Watch yourself. You know? Watch yourself.
Man, all I am saying is we are in our sexual prime, man. That little girl is going to bust up our flow.
Our flow? You mean the flow where I pick up the fine women and you scoop up their drunk, ugly friends?
Hey, man. Ugly girls are loyal, all right? All I'm saying is you were getting in way over your head.
Oh, man, I got this covered. This father thing is easy. I got a great job that's flexible. I don't have to be in the studio all the time, and when I'm on the road, my parents can babysit. And if I don't have them, I always got you.
Listen to my mama years ago.
Eunice, you're overreacting.
No, Richard, you're overheating.
Who are you flirting with this time, pal?
The deli girl at the Safeway. Oh, I saw you looking at her.
Not true. That was just a peek.
Oh, please.
Look. Peek.
Ma, Dad, what are y'all doing here?
Just think of us as your social workers. Hey, baby. Hey, are you okay?
I'm fine.
Are you sure? You look like you're losing weight.
And who put that outfit on you? Child looks like she's running from soap and water.
Look. Y'all have your way of raising children. I have mine.
Go run that girl a bath.
Yes, ma'am.
Yo, flex, man. It is two for one night over at Peanuts. There could be some angry secretaries getting their drink on.
Is that all you think about?
Women? Alcohol? Yeah, that's pretty much it.
All right, let me hear it. Hey, Dad, come here. Could you do me a favor? Could you watch Brianna for me tonight? The women of Baltimore are crying my name. Don't you hear them? Flex! Flex!
Flex! Flex!
Flex, nobody is crying for you. Now, you've got a daughter to raise. Look at this place. You need to make some changes around here. Well, like that motorcycle. Now, that's got to go.
Ma, the ladies love that motorcycle.
It doesn't even work.
Trust me, it works.
And another thing, what about school? Shots, her teeth.
Your mother's got a point, son. I'm looking at $5,000 worth of crooked right here.
You know, your lack of faith disturbs me. This is my baby. And I love her. There is nothing about this that I can't handle.
I think I look cute in a thong.
I can't handle this. You just made something that could be so beautiful so wrong.
Ooh, Teddy's. I'll be back in a minute.
Hi. Here's a pamphlet on father-daughter bra shopping.
Oh, good, because I'm looking for a bra that a teenage boy can't take off. Ooh, do you guys get paid off commission?
No.
Good, because I want her to help me. Excuse me.
Yes, can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to see something in a red bra and panties. Okay. Preferably you.
Does that work for you ever?
Well, it works better here than at Home Depot.
Wait a minute. Are you the sports guy from WYNX?
Not that, Flex Washington. So, can I get your phone number?
I don't have a pen. All I have is this lipstick.
Well, all I have is this. Write it on my heart.
Oh. So, like, are you really gonna call me Mr. Flat App Guy?
Right before I take a bath.
Excuse me, who are you?
Oh, I'm Tanya, and who do you belong to?
I'm with Flat App. Dad, let's go.
Look, it was nice meeting you.
No, it was nice meeting you. And if you had any more room left on your chest, I'd give you my cell number, too.
Well, I got plenty of room on my back.
Daddy.
And I'm glad this day is over. I was over at the University of Maryland at a football game. I got into a fight with the mascot.
Yeah. Well, at least we have our dates with Sonya and Tanya.
Yeah.
Mine's ugly, right?
No doubt.
Cool.
Uh-uh, girl, it's all computers. That is not D'Angelo's body. That's his head on Tyson's body.
Brianna, when you're watching a D'Angelo video, you better not be looking below the neck. Now, tell your friend bye-bye.
Yeah, that's my dad. Lately, he's been tripping about this phone. Girl, what's your email address?
Give me that phone.
So, guys, what we doing tonight? Chilling or clubbing?
Well, actually, I have to stay here and work. But you get to go have the time of your life at the racetrack with Grandma and Grandpa.
It's post time.
Okay, now that's them. I'll see you tomorrow, buddy. Come on.
But, Dad, you know what it's like going to the racetrack with Grandma and Grandpa. They get tapped out by the sixth race, and then they take your hot dog money.
All right, here's the extra five. Hide it. Oh, look who's here.
Dad, did you say you have to work or work it?
Hey, Tanya, Sonya, this is my buddy, Dwayne. Dwayne.
Ladies. If you are Tanya, you must be Sonya. I think I detect a hint of lazy eye, good looking out.
Wow, I have been looking forward to seeing you all day.
Well, all you had to do was catch me on TV. I'm always live at 5.
Daddy, I thought you and I were gonna hang out tonight. You know, like buddies?
That's right. Yeah, we are buddies. And do you know what a buddy would do for a buddy who had a date? She just go.
I don't know, Dad. Suddenly I'm not feeling very well. You better go. I don't want you to catch what I've got.
Oh, what a lovely child you have. Well, since she's not feeling well, maybe I should just go.
No.
No, we'll talk later.
No,
ladies, please, look, ignore the demon child.
Brianna, what is with this nasty little attitude?
I don't have a nasty little attitude.
Oh, yes, you do.
Oh, no, I don't.
You were rude and you disrespected my guest.
Come on, Daddy, stop tripping.
Brianna, go to your room.
Look at you trying to get all parental on a sister.
Brianna, you are grounded.
How you gonna ground me? I thought we were buddies.
Move it! She ain't going nowhere!
Man, spoiled baseball players can't play in low rain. So one guy on the field got struck by lightning. So what, man? For the money they make, you could stick a lightning rod up my ass and I would still keep swinging.
Look, I'm glad the game got rained out. It gives me some time to straighten things out with Brianna. I never had to punish her before.
Oh, come on, dog. Don't sweat it, all right? I'm sure she heard you loud and clear.
Thank you.
here.
Hello, the party you said I can have to make friends.
Brianna, you are grounded. We had an understanding.
Hey, I said I wouldn't leave the house, but they all came to me.
You I'm going to deal with.
How? You going to shake me like a British nanny?
Oh, so you don't think there's going to be some changes around here, huh? Okay, so I'm going to have to treat you like my parents treated me. Get out of my sight.
Wait a minute.
Don't you eyeball me.
So you're
talking back to me.
Are you talking?
I worked too hard.
Man, I'd be better off counting whales in Nova Scotia with Mom.
Man, all this talk about whales makes me want to go down to Lane Bryant and find myself a big bone girl. Which one?
Tanya, I'm so glad you're here.
So, where's Brianna?
Oh, she went to hang out with Dwayne for a while.
I can see that. They act about the same age.
Well, I know one thing. She hates my guts. At least that's the message I got from the note she left me.
Well, what did it say?
I hate your guts.
It's a hard age, you know? You're too old to play with dolls, too young to be an adult. Let's give it some time. She'll come around.
Well, how long did it take you?
You know, I'm almost ready to have my first real conversation with my dad.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Well, who's your daddy now?
Hey, guys. Seen Brianna?
What?
Well, you see, we were at the movies, and I got hungry, so I went out to buy a box of Sour Patch Kids. But, you know, I already had a box of Melt Duds, and I want to cut the sweetness.
Dwayne, what happened?
I went back, and she was gone. I only thought that happened with my dates.
Okay, then I gotta find my baby. We're gonna go back to the movie theater and see if anybody saw her. We'll call the police on the way there.
Now, I'm sure we're gonna find her. Found her.
Brianna, why did you run away from Dwayne?
Well, I was sitting there and Dwayne was gone, so I asked myself, is this how it's gonna be? Me by myself all the time. So I called Grandma and Grandpa and they came and got me.
Why did you call me?
Why? You don't care.
What?
Brianna, honey, why don't you take the ice cream and go to your room?
Can I have sprinkles?
Oh, no, baby, you're being punished.
All right, let me have it.
For starters, why did you leave the child with Dwayne?
Flex, you're the father, she's the daughter. Only one of you can act like you're 14.
What am I supposed to do? I tried being cool with her. I tried being stern with her. Nothing works.
Have you tried talking to her? Now, I know you're gonna say, we never talked to you, but look how you turned out. For God's sake, learn from our mistake.
Are you saying I'm a mistake?
Well, your mother was a young and beautiful school teacher, and I was in the Army.
Richard.
That's another conversation, son.
But I figured the best way to discipline her is to do what you guys did with me.
Whip you with a hairbrush?
No, Ma, be tough. Lay down the law.
Son, that's a bunch of bull. We did an awful job. Mm-hmm. Just look at you. You were married at 18, you had a baby at 19, and you were divorced at 20.
And I'll never forgive you for making me a grandmother at 32.
32?
That's right. The point is, you've got a daughter you hardly know.
And you've got to fix that. Raising Brianna is a big responsibility, son. Are you sure you can handle it?
Hey, what you doing?
Playing one on none.
Okay, so how about we play a little game, okay? Every time one of us makes a shot, the other one has to answer a question, all right? So, you think we got a shot at making this thing work?
Better than that shot you just took.
Okay, so how about this? What were you trying to prove by running away?
I don't answer any questions till you make a shot.
You're right. Those are the rules. My roof. My rules.
With Mom left, I thought everything was going to be cool, like always. But I feel like I'm in the way and you don't want me here.
Baby, you can never be in the way. And I know I've made some mistakes. But with your help, I know I can be a better father.
So that means you're gonna stop seeing Tanya?
No. Because I'm also gonna try to be a better single father. And I'm gonna date. But But Brianna, you're the most important person in my life. Trust me, no woman can replace you in my heart. Or apparently in my backcourt. Oh, she smiles. I haven't seen that in a while. So look, there's gonna be some new rules around here, right?
That's cool, as long as we can talk about them.
Any topic, anytime.
Really? Why do you have a mirror over your bed?
Daddy likes to shave while he's lying down. But it's gone tomorrow. Anything else?
Yeah, can my boyfriend...
Nope.
I thought you said we could talk.
We just did. All right, check this out. Vince Carter, half court behind back, no looking, looking. Flat at.
Flat not. Okay. Kobe Bryant, take me to the prom after I do a crossover dribble.
All right, girl. Give up the rock. Come on, give up the rock. What you got to give? Didn't want to have to go old school on you, but I think I just might have to. Dr. J like an ABA with a big old fro. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Telescopic, slam dunk, throw down.
Go ahead.
Yeah!
All right, Daddy. You know, this is my first time voting, so I'm going to have some big questions.
Oh, I've waited for this day when you would come to me to have a serious talk about our political process. So lay it on me.
Okay. What outfit should I wear? Should I wear this outfit that says I'm concerned about the issues but still sexy? Or should I wear this outfit that says I may be a little conservative, but I'm still a rebel?
Brianna, voting is a privilege, not a fashion statement. Go with the rebel.
I'm doomed! Don't try to stop me, Flex. I'm jumping!
All right, just don't land on my truck.
Don't you even want to know why I'm jumping?
We trust your judgment. Oh, wait, before you kill yourself, it's my first time voting. So, which one? Sexy or rebel?
I'm talking about ending my life and all you can think about is yourself? Yeah, go with rebel.
Thank you.
Well, now that I've solved her problem, man, who's gonna help me solve mine? Look at this.
Ooh, $20,000 in charges. Ooh, just make sure you land in front of a bus. Go ahead.
No way. These charges aren't mine. I'm the victim of identity theft.
Wait, who would want to be you?
Very funny. But you guys are gonna miss me when I'm in prison.
Oh, relax, D. You're not gonna go to prison. Fraud happens all the time. Those credit card companies are not gonna hold you responsible for those charges.
Really?
Yeah, that's why they're insured. Man, that guy could buy everything in a Sharper Image catalog with your credit card, and you would not have to pay a dime.
Wouldn't have to pay a dime, huh?
No, not at all.
Huh. But, Dwayne, would you like to go shopping?
Why, yes, I would. You treat me so well. Well, you deserve it.
I'll get you something.
Sometimes in this life, you can feel all by yourself.
Check, one, two.
But I have a partner, but I can't trust no one else. When there's nobody around,
oh, yeah.
I'll be there to think of then. What a true love we have found. Can't nobody break this bond. One on one. Just because now we have a thing. One on one.
Goofing off. Those buttons are supposed to have my cousin Larry's picture on them, not yours.
I know, baby. I was making this one for you. Who's your mayor?
You, boo.
Yeah. I can't believe Larry Eldridge is your cousin. He's got charisma, he's got style, and he is fine. If he was my cousin, we'd be taking this relationship to West Virginia.
If he was your cousin, he'd be on lockdown. And just because Councilman Eldridge is your cousin doesn't mean you have to vote for him.
Yes, I do.
Oh, really? Why?
Daddy, can you tell Arnez why our family always votes for Cousin Larry?
Sit down. Because he's family, and you know how your grandpa is. Never go against the family. Especially when it comes to Larry, the golden child.
My daddy and my cousin Larry are always competing with each other.
Well, your dad's all right, but your cousin Larry, he's smart and powerful. He's like a chocolate Kennedy.
Oh, he is not all that. But ever since we were kids, all I ever heard was, you should be more like your cousin Larry. He went to Harvard. He was the youngest city councilman in Baltimore history. The Clintons invited him to sleep in the Lincoln bedroom. Oh, yeah? Well, Puffy didn't invite him to the all-white party in the Hamptons. 2 years in a row, yo. All white.
Well, I'm not sure if I'm gonna vote for him as mayor or the incumbent Peter Shepard. And I'm still trying to figure out who to vote for president.
Arnaz, I can't tell you who to vote for president, but all I can do is tell you to use your judgment and vote for the least scary white man running.
Well, as long as he's cute.
Spirit, you can't pick a candidate based on how he looks. If that's the case, Denzel will be president, and I'll be vice president. Be the two fine Washingtons. I mean, really.
This is a really important election for Baltimore, and nationally, too. And not just because of Supreme Court nominations or gun control.
See, Daddy? He's not just all muscle.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the next mayor of Baltimore is Larry!
Hello to all. Hello, everybody. Hello, hello.
Well, if it isn't my favorite cousin, Larry, the one who stole the trophy from the last family reunion by cheating in the three-legged race.
I didn't cheat. It didn't say nothing in the rule books about roller skates. Loopholes, Flex. You gotta look for the loophole.
Potholes. I'm looking at the pothole. When you gonna fix the streets, Councilman?
Flex, Flex, now play nice. Remember, Larry has hooked it up for us to play at the country club today. You know, there was a day when people like us couldn't get in there.
Yeah, well, unless you change your clothes, we still ain't gonna get in there.
Wow, Brianna, I got to admit, I really appreciate you getting my voice out to McKinley High. First-time voters are very important.
Yes, I know. I can't wait. I've been reading all my voting pamphlets and been studying all of those propositions.
It's good you're doing your homework. And it's also good you're voting for me. You know, a first-time voter like yourself normally stays loyal, which is good for future elections. Who knows? Maybe one day you could be voting for me to be president.
What? You for president? Man, who in their right mind would want to vote for a bedwetter? That's right, I said it. Pee all up in the bed, all in your Shazam pajamas.
Cut me, Flex. Cut me deep. Just like when Knicks cut you.
Oh! Vote for Eldridge! Vote for Eldridge!
Down with Eldridge!
Hey, where have you guys been? I thought you were upstairs putting up posters.
We put them up, and then these people came along.
They are just as fired up about the election as we are. And they have donuts.
Yep, and they have flyers. Look, this says that my cousin Larry is trying to close McKinley because of budget cuts.
So we're only going to school for half the year? I'm not sure I'm mad at that.
No, shut McKinley down for good. Why do they always cut back the arts? Why don't they cut back something we don't use? Like math.
Or geography. I mean, for real, who needs geography when we can just look stuff up on MapQuest?
Maybe it's propaganda. My Larry wouldn't do this. He's got class. Did you see those shoes he had on? Gators. My mom would probably hate him for it because, you know, the whole animal thing. But once I'm First Lady of Baltimore, I'm sure she'll get over it.
Look, you guys, I'm sure my family wouldn't back Cousin Larry if they knew he supported something like this. Maybe they don't have all the information.
Well, don't you think they ought to know? I mean, voting is a privilege. You shouldn't just give it away.
You're right. And before I go to the polls, I want to know everything there is to know. So come on, let's go to the rally and hear what they have to say.
Yeah, because I want to know why they hating on my man.
This club's kind of long, don't you think, Dwayne?
Well, I figure as long as Dwayne is rich, he's also going to be very, very tall.
You're going to need a lawyer if you think you can get away with this.
Come on, man. Look, I just want to live the life that this guy is stealing from me for 24, 48, 72 hours.
You're absolutely right. I think Baltimore would be the perfect place for a nuclear power plant. Yeah, why invest in the sun? It can't burn forever.
My cousin Larry.
And I'll make sure it gets to the Boys Club of America.
Larry, you make the family so proud, keeping up our tradition of being involved. It warms my heart to see you following your father's footsteps, unlike some people.
I'm sorry, Pop, that I don't share your love for hair or Larry's love for polyester.
Flex, why you hate? I'm your cousin. We grew up together. I want to be close with you. But you won't even go on the campaign trail with me. Is it because I'm prettier than you?
Prettier than me? Come on, man, you got a handful of teeth, man. Well, I can't endorse any candidate, man. Now, I'm a journalist who's both local and national with a syndicated talk show.
No, you're a sports reporter. I mean, you're not even a real journalist. They don't show you till the news is over. I mean, you're on even after the weather.
Councilman Eldridge, over here.
About time.
What's going on?
Well, since you didn't want to come on the campaign trail with me, I brought it to you, cousin. Mr. Nationally Syndicated. It's called good old finger-licking politicking.
Yeah, I hope you choke on a wing.
That's okay, long as it's a right wing. Vote for Larry.
Flex Washington. Can we assume you're playing golf with Councilman Eldridge means you endorse him?
Oh, well, Tammy, I'm just playing a friendly round of golf with my cousin.
Well, who would play golf with family they don't vote for? And by the way, Tammy, you still rolling? Well, let me show you my good side then.
In that case, bend over.
How about that course Larry took us to, huh, son? I haven't seen grass that green since I picked out those plots for me and your mother.
Oh, that's great, Dad. I'm gonna get something cold to drink.
Well, I have a little Cristal chilling in my new Sub-Zero, which I'm returning tomorrow. Or the day after that. Or the day after that.
How about that, Larry, huh, Dad? Trying to ambush me with all that press. Not that I don't look good on camera. Man, he's so political.
He's a politician, Flex, and he's family. You should be out there supporting him. Why aren't you out there supporting him?
Dad, you know how I hate getting into discussions about politics, especially when it comes to Larry.
No, I don't. Say what you feel, son.
Okay. I am not feeling Larry for mayor.
What are you talking about? That's just nonsense. He's a wonderful candidate, he's family, and I don't want to hear another word about
it. Dad, he seems to end up on the wrong side of the issues. And we fall right in line with him because he's family.
That's absurd. Like when?
Like when the new stadium was built. All the other councilmen got tickets for everybody in the neighborhood. Not Larry. He made sure his corporate friends and his country club buddies had tickets. Do you know how many people in the city can't afford to see a baseball game?
See, now that's where you're wrong. I was there opening day, and all I had to do was cut his hair and park his car.
Breaking news. Apparently, the students at McKinley School of the Performing Arts are protesting Councilman Larry Eldridge in his bid for mayor and are staging a protest right here in the school's gymnasium.
That's Brianna's school. How did she let that happen? You're supposed to be shouting for Larry, not against him.
I'm sure Brianna is not involved in this, Pop.
I got the bubbly. Although with the new Sub-Zero, it's more like a champagne slushy. What was it?
That's a McKinley High School protest being led by my granddaughter against her cousin Larry.
Pop, don't worry about it. Nobody watches the afternoon news.
We'll have full coverage of the Eldridge protest at 5, 6, and 11. Back to you, Stan.
Flex, you got to go get Brianna. She is on TV protesting against the family.
Pop, she's not one of the Sopranos. Look, she's only doing what you've done. And what I've done.
mean, you marched with Dr. King for civil rights. I marched with Stevie Wonder for the King holiday. I mean, the way I see it, she's keeping up with the family tradition, learning the power of her right to vote and to speak out.
Well, I hope those cops who just came in there are as understanding as you are.
5-0, I gotta get my baby. Brianna, what are you doing?
Participating in a non-violent political protest.
And affecting change. Hey, can I borrow $10? They're not taking me seriously without the t-shirt.
Yeah, Ernest, it's the t-shirt. All right, come on, Brianna, we go.
Uh-uh, Daddy, I'm not going anywhere. Down with my cousin Larry!
Baby, I think it's great that you're standing up for what you believe in and that you're the facilitator for change. But do you realize if you go to jail that you're gonna have to pee in front of a bunch of strangers?
But, Daddy, if Cousin Larry becomes mayor, he's talking about shutting down McKinley and anything that has to do with the arts, just to save money.
You know, it's just like him not to appreciate something that doesn't put money in his pocket, art hater. And to think, he used to eat his crayons.
That's why we're doing this, Daddy, to get the word out there so people won't vote for him.
So, Mr. Washington, are you with us?
Somebody else asked me.
Are you with us?
Somebody else, please.
So, are you with us, Daddy?
Finally. Yes, yes, I'm with you, I'm with you, I'm with you.
Here.
Down with Larry! Down with Larry! Down with Larry! Down with Larry! Down with Larry!
Welcome to Town About Town. I'm Tammy Towne. Young America's fascination with voting has taken McKinley High by storm.
Yeah, Tammy, it's a registration storm. The loon and slum village is definitely in the house. We making sure anybody out there that want to be heard, come on out and register on November 2nd. Come on out and vote.
Yeah, yeah, remember what happened in 2000. Every vote counts, three more. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, I'd like to give a shout out. What up there, Detroit, East Southern Live?
Apparently, every vote does count. What started out as an innocent protest by the students is quickly becoming a potential disaster for Councilman Larry Eldridge and his quest for mayor. Despite his lead in the polls, this outcry from Baltimore's youth could sway the outcome. I'm going to try to interview one of the protesters now. Excuse me, protester? Could you tell the people of Baltimore exactly what you hope to achieve with this protest?
We're trying to show the people what Councilman Eldridge stands for. If you care about art, if you care about culture, if you care about inner city kids being in a controlled environment and not in your house, you would not vote for a man who would cut arts programs. No justice, no peace, no thieves. Thank you.
Relax, Washington.
Hey, Tammy Town. What are you doing about town?
For those of you who don't know, this is Flex Washington of WYNX, one of the smaller affiliates.
Number one sports show, newly syndicated talk show, The Flex Files. That's why right now, change your channel.
They can't change the channel, Flex. They can't take their eyes off this protest. And they're all wondering how you could be supporting Councilman Eldridge this morning, yet you're protesting him right now.
Well, Tammy, see, I know it's unorthodox for a journalist to express his political opinion, but come on now, I'm on after the weather. And besides, my daughter reminded me of something that I should have never forgotten. To stand up for what you believe in!
Yeah!
Even if that means voting against your own cousin?
That's right, if he's wrong. And Closing McKinley is wrong. These children are our future, and I believe in them. I believe the children are our future. Teach them well, then let them lead the way.
Show them all!
That is all the time we have for today. And thank you for showing us what the world would be like without the arts. Back to you, Stan.
Well, I never thought I'd see the day when my children and my children's children would be in shackles.
I know, Dad, but isn't it more important that these kids see that with their vote, they can change things?
You're right, son. And that's why I came down here, to do something important. Who here is 18 and not registered to vote?
Grandpa, you're joining our protest?
Baby, my knees are too old to protest, and I'm still voting for Larry. But I wanted to support my children. Just like I say, one family, one voice. So, vote or die.
Vote or die. Vote or die. Vote or die. Vote or die.
Hit
you people security? No. How can one man use my credit card in several different cities at the same time? No, no! I've been a member since 89. This is how I'm treated. Fix it. Brand new motor scooter, $3,700. 41-inch high-definition flat-screen television, $5,000. Not having to pay for anything, priceless. Oh, yeah. And the new treadmill came on in. Working like a charm. It's getting really...
And it seems the mayoral race is much closer than expected. Councilman Larry Eldridge, who had a 40% lead in the polls just yesterday, is almost neck and neck with incumbent Peter Shepard. We'll be back with more election night coverage.
Well, you can't say your vote didn't make a difference. I'm proud of you, baby.
Thanks, Daddy. I'm proud of you, too.
My little baby's growing up. Maybe one day you'll run for president.
Yeah, and I'll be the first man.
And that's just what Washington needs, another dummy.
Race, it looks like the youth of America voted in droves, not only locally, but nationally. Right now, our polls indicate the projected winner is...
Hey, Dion, I'm glad to see you finally decided to return this stuff, man.
Of course I'd return the stuff. I have no idea why the person who stole my identity would have it all delivered to my apartment.
You know, I'm still trying to figure out who would want to be you in the first place.
I'm staying at the Bellagio, going to eat dinner at Aqua, and have young, hot men up to my penthouse suite every night. No harm, no foul. Especially when some of the chumps paying for it. Ooh, it's a new day, Celine. Woohoo!
Can you believe Miss Beam gave me a C in home ec? I mean, who needs boiling a bag of rice when you got all this ready-made cuteness?
Speaking of fast food, look what Arnez picked up at the drive-thru.
I'll talk to you later, Valencia.
Bye. Valencia. She's named after an orange. Oh, she looks fresh squeezed. The spirit is okay. Arnez and I are just friends.
Right.
He can go out with any fruit that he wants to.
Thanks, but I think I might be moving on to vegetables. Hey, pumpkin.
Hey, this fell out of your locker.
Oh, that's not mine.
Ode to Brianna. Hair dark and lovely. Skin Neutrogena. I know in my heart, I need you like Aquafina.
A glance of you is never enough. That Victoria's Secret body, man, it's four tubs. Sign me.
Oh, girl, you got a secret admirer.
Oh, I wonder who it could be.
I don't know, but we know one thing. You watch a lot of commercials.
Sometimes it's not, you can feel all by yourself.
Yeah, one, two.
But I have a partner, but I can't trust no one else. So don't isolate yourself when there's nobody around.
Oh, yeah.
I'll be there.
Prove once again that he's the toughest little man on the court. Nothing short of brilliant. Holly?
Ooh, let's dish. After the game, Ivy got a new heart tattoo. Does he have a new boo? Me thinks love is in the air.
Love has nothing to do with sports.
What if it's tennis, Flexi Doodle? Each game starts love, love, just like you and me.
That's all for tonight's Flex Files. Flat at...
Holly Holla!
Are we out yet? Thank you. Now then, please, someone take out the trash. She's stinking up my show.
Oh, please, Flex. Your show was fairly pungent before I got here. That's why management brought me in. I'm the Sancho Panza to your Don Quixote.
No, you're more like the donkey to my Don Quixote. Thanks, Shiz.
Ooh.
Oh, it's a fax from Geraldine.
Oh,
Emma. Apparently, our producer took time out from vacationing on Liposuction Island to send us something.
Yeah. Jerry's landed WYNX an exclusive with former NFL running back Eric Dickerson.
You know, the word is he's been offered a coaching position with a Division I school.
Exactly, but he's being real tight-lipped about this one. And if I can break this story, it'll get picked up nationally.
What would the irritatingly effervescent Holly wear national? I know. Daisy Dukes and Gucci boots.
That Baywatch reject comes all up in my space talking about what's Holly gonna wear national? How about a noose?
Flex, please. I know you're under a lot of stress, but in a couple hours, I'm going under the knife and donating a kidney to my father in a county hospital. Oh, but I'm sorry. Please, continue with your drama.
I'm done.
Dwayne, I can't tell you how much I appreciate you doing this for me.
Don't worry about it, Pop. But we're square for the next couple Christmases. All right. Anyways, any surgery comes with some risks.
Dwayne, everything's gonna be fine. I'm not worried. Now, are we done?
I just have one small presentation. Good evening. And if this syndicates, buenas noches. You are watching the last will and testament of one Dwayne Odell Knox. I, being of sound mind and body, do bequeath.
This is ridiculous, Dwayne. Everything is gonna be all right. Now, back to me. Who do you like better, me or Holly?
So, I questioned the guys at school, and nothing. So I'm thinking your secret admirer must be Winky, the janitor. Or I'm gonna go out on a limb and say Miss Kaufman, the gym teacher.
Whoever it is, they didn't include a picture, so we know they're ugly. And we all know Miss Kaufman is not cute.
Get you a tip. My secret admirer. Read the card while I take care of the delivery guy.
Hey, your secret admirer spells your name wrong. Biana. What an idiot!
Idiot? The name is Brianna, and I specifically asked for roses. How are some tired carnations gonna convince him that I too can have someone hot for me? No tip for you.
Thanks for coming in, Eric. Let's get started. This is just a little pre-interview, you know what I'm saying? I don't like to ambush my guests, that way we're both prepared.
Okay, let's get started. But before I forget, don't ask me anything about where I'm gonna be coaching. I'm still working out the details of my deal.
Oh, got it. So since you retired from the NFL, you've been doing color commentary from the sidelines. And has Michigan State offered you a coaching job yet? And how's your golf game?
Flex, Eric doesn't want to talk about boring things like his golf game. He wants to talk about fun stuff. Like my girlfriend Susan Watanabe said that you dated Miss Michigan. How'd you like her slopes?
Well,
back off, Holly. No one's interested in hearing Susan Watanabe's gossip and Miss Michigan's slopes.
Well, they were man-made.
They were. Enough. Look, Holly, I've never heard such blatant, mindless drivel.
Who am I, Flex? In 1984, you rushed 2,105 yards. Somebody oil me.
Look, I am trying to do a real sports show. The Flex Files, not Holly's Hooters.
I'd watch that show.
Thank you.
I'm gonna let you two work this out. Just ask me the rest of the questions.
You see what I'm talking about, Holly? Huh? You see what you did? When are you gonna learn that you being here is not an asset, it's a liability?
It looks like somebody's not keeping abreast of the S&P. I've taken you from penny stock to blue chip without any exorbitant commission. This is our shtick, Flex. You do the sports, I'm the entertainment.
The Flex Files is not entertainment. It's information that entertains. It's infotainment.
Flex, like it or not, you need me.
No, the peroxide companies need you to stay in business. So, like your ends, I'm gonna split.
You'll swing me by the plastic surgery award tomorrow so I can get some after pictures, right? Hey, man, come on, don't
tell me you ain't even a little curious to see how that woman's tummy tuck turned out.
They have a surgery for that? I just tucked my extra tummy into my belt. So, what's your name?
Dwayne.
What? You're pulling my IV.
My name's Dwayne, too.
Huh.
Hey, I hate hospitals. Man, they really creep me out. You know people die here.
People are also born here.
Yeah, but people also die here.
People are also born here. You know what? We're not getting anywhere. Besides, we're both Dwaynes, and nothing bad ever happens to Dwaynes. So what are you in for?
Oh, I'm getting a kidney transplant.
Get out! Man, I'm giving a kidney. How about that? Two Dwaynes in the same hospital, same room, one to give a kidney, one to get a kidney. What are the odds of that?
Huh.
Hey, Daddy.
You just called my daddy, Daddy.
No, you just called my daddy, Daddy.
Daddy, who is this?
Don't call him Daddy.
Stop doing that.
No, you stop doing that.
Daddy!
So they put you in the same room before the operation.
Why is he calling you Daddy, Daddy?
Boys, this is all very complicated. You two are half brothers. Well, now that I say it, it sounds rather simple.
But simple, it's sick. You even gave us the same name, man. What kind of George Foreman madness is this?
I made sure the names were spelled differently. Dwayne and Dwayne.
Daddy, you told me you were getting my kidney from a brother. Not my brother.
Now it all makes sense. That's why you weren't there the other day I got my blood test. That's why you disappeared when I was getting admitted.
Listen, son.
Oh.
The reason I didn't come clean about everything at first was because I thought it would be too much for you to handle all at once.
So let me get this straight. If your new son didn't need your old son's kidney, you never would have come looking for me.
Son, like I told you before, when I found out you were looking for me, I wanted to meet you. But then when this happened to Dwayne, I had to find you, Dwayne. Maybe I'm going about this the wrong way. I should have listened to Dwayne's mother.
Oh, so you didn't abandon his mother? Oh, let me guess, you guys got a white picket fence, a dog, and you live by Disneyland.
No, actually, we have an iron fence with a cat, and we live in a little cul-de-sac by SeaWorld.
Now, all this time, I thought you lived here in Baltimore.
No, we just moved. And we're expecting a second child. That's why his mom's not here.
Well, my mom would have been here, but she knew that you were going to be here. You with your perfect life and your perfect house near a performing fish.
Daddy, I'm kind of cold. Could you hand me that blanket over there?
Okay, son. Dwayne?
Yes.
Dwayne?
Yes.
Not you, boy.
May I? Spirit, why are you dressed like Dreadlock Holmes? Because I enjoy solving mysteries in my spare time. That, and it's laundry day. Anyway, I'm on to you. It took me a while, but I've cracked the case of the mysterious secret admirer.
What you've cracked is your head.
It's you. You're your own secret admirer. Yes, it was all in the first clue, the poem. You spoke of Neutrogena and Dark and Lovely, two of your favorite beauty products.
I don't know what you were talking about.
Oh, no. You mentioned Victoria's Secret, which is somewhere you've always wanted to shop, but your father won't let you.
It's not true, I say. It's not true. Explain the Ford reference.
What do you think I am, an amateur? I remembered in history class you said your favorite president was Gerald Ford.
You were so clumsy and misunderstood.
But my only question is why, Breonna Barnes, why?
I love him, I hate him, I love him, I hate him. Oh, I bit my tongue. Look, I thought if I can fool Arnaz into believing that I had a secret admirer, it might convince him that I moved on too. And I would have gotten away with it if it wasn't for you and your Olsen twin videos. Hey.
Well, I'm sure Dwayne's in surgery right now. Think I can call him on the cell phone?
Daddy, can you go one day without talking to him?
Not this day. Today, I need my little buddy.
Well, I'm here. You can talk to me.
I appreciate that, but this is adult stuff. You know, it's all too complicated. Oh, Snickers.
Okay, Daddy, I'll leave you with your adult problems.
Okay, it's like this. I don't want to share the Flex files with Holly. Those are my files. I filed them myself. Ask me what's in them. Like, ask me what's in them.
Daddy.
She don't know.
Daddy.
I know it.
Daddy, look. I'm a cheerleader. Do you think I enjoy sharing the spotlight with eight other girls? Even if I am the cutest, and I am. Look, you can't build a pyramid by yourself.
I think I know what you're saying. Sometimes it takes a team to do something really exciting.
That's exactly what I'm saying. Be willing to share the spotlight. But darn it, make sure you're the cutest.
Hey, hey, listen up. Oh, I guess you can't because you're sleeping. But, I can't go through with this. I mean, I know you're a great kid and all, but this is just too much for me. So I'm gonna say goodbye. And I'm gonna take your pudding cup. And, slide it closer to you. Here you go. Oh, it's you. I'm just gonna get my things and get out of your life for good. And by things, I mean my kidneys.
Please. I know I've disappointed you again. And I'm sorry again. I could have told you the truth earlier, but I just didn't want my second son to be punished for the way I mistreated my first.
Yeah, Dad. You have mistreated me. I don't need a kidney. But I've never felt more pain than I'm feeling right now. I've been lied to, deceived, and almost cut open. I mean, I wouldn't mind if you were a complete stranger, but you're my dad.
But I'm also his dad. And all the things I did wrong for you, I tried to do right for him. I taught him how to ride a bike. I helped him with his homework. I talked to him about girls.
Did you ever, pop caps with a hammer, or burn ants with a magnifying glass. Ooh, did you ever have them use crutches so you can get a better parking space at the ballpark? Just, some of the things I wanted to do with you.
No, I never got a chance to do those things. And son, if you don't help him, I may never get that chance.
Hey, old dad, the crutches thing sounds pretty fun. You think we can do it?
I don't know, Dwayne. Can we, Dwayne?
I don't know. Can my little brother come?
Thank you, son. Well, let me go get the doctor and get this show on the road.
So, let me make sure I got everything straight here, Eric. You can still run a 4840. You love working with young athletes, and I'm sorry I can't read my handwriting. What school did you say you'd be coaching at?
Flex, I told you I can't talk about any coaching possibilities.
Oh, come on, E. This is big news. We're talking about being one of only 5 black coaches at Division I schools.
Sorry, Flex. I'm not talking.
Nah, I can't break you, huh? You're a tough nut to crack. How about something lighter? Holly?
Yes, Pop?
Time for a little
You're offside, Mr. Dickerson. Let's dish. My girlfriend, Susan Watanami, her aunt's cousin said that she saw you shopping at Saks buying fur coats. True or false?
True. I like to look good.
Oh, I like to stay fly myself, player. Keep going, Holly.
We also heard you spent the weekend on Mackinac Island.
Yeah, getting your Mac on.
I was not there getting my Mac on.
So, you were there on business then?
What business would be on Mackinac Island? Ice fishing? Me thinks not. I even heard
heard you were there with three very attractive ladies learning how to cross-country ski. Susan Watanabe says you have very powerful thighs. Ooh, she's right.
Fur coat, cross-country skiing on Mackinac Island. What do these things have in common? Sounds to me like somebody's getting ready to move to Michigan. You're gonna coach the Spartans. Come on.
Yeah, yeah, it's true.
Go, Eric.
Congratulations, Eric. You heard it here first on the Flex Files. Flat App and...
Holly Hanna.
Sports Illustrated's gonna kill me. I'm supposed to give them an exclusive.
Oh, don't worry about it. Tell them to give me a call. I'll give them a quote.
I tell you, Flex, we're a great team.
Yes, we are. But I am the quarterback of this team, and you are the kicker at best.
All right. I'll sit on the sidelines for now. But watch out, because when it comes time to win the big game, this kicker kicks butt. Ow! Oh, leg cramp.
Oh, I'm sorry. The kicker can't kick it? Holly, help her?
Yeah. Come on.
Looks like your mystery guy struck again.
My dearest Brianna, it is with a broken heart that I must end our relationship. Please do not take this as cliche, but it was I who was not right for you. It was I who didn't deserve you. It was I who...
It's over.
Lots of love, bye-bye. It just wasn't meant to be.
Forget him, Brianna. If this guy was too scared to show his face, he's probably ugly anyway. I gotta run.
Come on now, Brianna. I thought you were done with this secret admirer stuff.
But I didn't do this. From your other secret admirer. What? Who? You know what? Y'all get on my nerves.
Happy Breakfast might have been fine with Hank, but as your new producer, I want my anchors lean and mean.
Smack my bagel again, Geraldine, and I'll show you mean.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah.
Now, see, we're drinking our breakfast this morning. You do know that's what got Hank fired, right?
This is coffee, not wild turkey. And I believe it was driving his car through the lobby that got Hank fired.
Well, in his defense, he did yell, "Watch out, it's happy hour!" Nah, I'm really gonna miss the guy.
Well, I'm not gonna miss the lousy ratings.
Hey, my ratings are fine. I'm number one with men 25 and older.
I don't care about men over 25.
I'm sure the feeling's mutual.
Is we dump a lot of money into your weekend flex files, and the desired demographic is men 18 to 24.
Well, my desired demographic are women who don't talk to me while I'm eating.
Sometimes in this life, you can feel all by yourself.
Check, one, two.
But I have a partner, but I can't trust no one else. So don't isolate yourself when there's nobody around.
Oh, yeah.
I'll be there.
So, Flex, what are we having for Thanksgiving dinner this year?
Oh, all the trimmings. Turkey, homemade oyster stuffing, yams, macaroni and cheese, collard greens, and sweet potato pie.
Daddy, so when is all this being delivered?
Noon, Thursday.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Let's get up in this. Come on now.
Yeah, take that right there for yourself.
What is this, store-bought maple syrup? Man, I have a whole bucket of fresh tapped.
Where did you get a bucket of fresh tapped maple syrup?
Let's just say I'm no longer welcome at the Botanical Gardens. I go get it.
Daddy, you aren't gonna wait for Dwayne's fresh tap syrup?
Sweetie, there are no maple trees in the Botanical Garden.
Hello, Dwayne.
Hello.
Dwayne, calm down. Calm down.
Daddy, I'm not Dwayne. I'm Julius, Dwayne's flamboyant dog walker.
It's me, son. Your father.
Yeah, right. Like I'm supposed to believe every burglar who breaks in claiming to be my father. Well, how do I know you're not some swindler, some grifter, someone trying to steal my fortune in an in-home game of three-card Monte?
You got me confused with your mama's brother, Uncle Wendell the Swindle.
Well, everybody knows about Uncle Wendell the Swindle.
Does everybody know about those three moles on your back in the shape of a mouse?
You know about Mickey Mole? Daddy, is that really you?
It's me.
Oh, Daddy! Where the hell have you been? And why did you run away from me when I went to your apartment looking for you?
I didn't know it was you. All I knew was somebody tapped into my computer and got my address.
But why did you break into my apartment, leave your watch, and not even say hi?
I guess I was ashamed. I wasn't ready to face you.
But why now?
Well, I've been here for 3 hours and I still can't find my watch.
I'm not joking, Dad. Where were you?
Son, when I first met your mama, I told her I was not the settling down type. We were both really young, but I'm older now. And let's just say it's time to set some things right.
That's not good enough.
I got some bubble gum.
Daddy!
There you are. Brianna, I just met with a recruiter from the Fashion Institute, and he said that I have potential and can qualify for a scholarship, but I have to come up with an original design by the end of this week.
Look at Arnaz talking to that girl. That's probably the hoochie he lost his virginity to. I can't believe I was gonna give it up to him thinking he was giving it up to me, only find out he gave it up to her. Well, let's give it up for the hoochie.
Brianna, that's the cafeteria lady.
Girl, he won't tell me who it was. It could be anybody. It's driving me crazy. Ooh, here he comes. Let's pretend like we're not talking about him. Oh, hey, Ernest.
Hey, guys. What's going on?
Nothing. We just had our college interviews. Trying to figure out which co-ed dorms I want to live in.
Thought you didn't want to go to college.
Yeah, there's a lot of things I thought I wanted to do, but I don't want to do anymore.
Maybe we should think about U of A, University of Arnaz. Always accepting applications.
Yeah, that's the problem. I hear it's very easy to get into.
Can we get back to my problem? Okay, I only have a week to impress this recruiter, or else I'm gonna wallow in mediocrity for the rest of my life.
Why should your future be any different than your past?
This is serious. Look, Brianna, you've got your daddy, the TV guy, who can send you to college. And Arnaz, you got those huge guilt payments from your philandering daddy. Me? My parents are two black hippies who run an incense shop. Okay, incense cart. But I have to get a scholarship to go to college.
Okay, girl, what can we do to help?
Okay, I have to come up with an original outfit. But what can I do? It's all been done.
Wait, it's only all been done until someone else thinks of it. Take leather shoes, for instance. People were walking around barefoot until someone looked at a cow and thought, I bet I could wear that. Now all you have to do is find your cow.
Where am I gonna find my cow?
Well, maybe Arnaz can help. So what was the name of that hoochie?
Hey, Geraldine. I worked on a little something to bring in 18 and 24-year-olds, a new opening for the Flex Files. Check out the little track I put together. It's hot, it's hot. Flex one, flex two, the Flex Files. It's Flex Dream, y'all. It's Flex and Lizzle, Flex and Nizzle. Flex!
Yeah, it sounds flex stupid. What you need is what every man 18 to 24 needs. One of those. That's your new sexy sidekick. She trained under Brokaw. Interpret that how you will.
Everyone here at Winx is so nice.
Actually, it's just W-Y-N-X.
Oh, it's Winx. I'm so embarrassed.
Flex, I'd like you to meet Holly Spears. Mm.
Hi, Holly Spears. Any relation to Britney Spears?
No, but I know a Britney who works at Sears.
Isn't she great? She'll be the perfect sidekick for you. For this weekend's Flex Files, I need you guys to work out a cute little bit, okay?
Good. Mm-hmm.
So, what kind of bits you want to do?
How about you don't talk to me and I pretend you don't exist?
Am I doing it right?
That's me in
mama at the Salem tobacco field.
I can hear your mama wheezing.
So have you called mama yet?
No, son, she doesn't want to hear from me.
Good, I didn't want to have to be the one to tell you.
So tell me more about you. You're not doing any drugs or drinking, are you?
Well, I do enjoy the occasional glass of Merlot while I'm taking a bubble bath like any other guy.
Right.
Hey, what's up, D? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know you had company.
Oh, he's not company. He's my father.
You mean...
That's right, man. My daddy came back. Oh, Dad, this is Flex.
How you doing? Dwayne's dad.
Wow, Dwayne's dad. So, what do we owe this long overdue, sudden out of the blue visit to your son? Just cruise in the neighborhood?
I know what you're gonna say, Flex. But my son and I have agreed to put the past behind us.
Exactly. What matters is that he's here now.
Oh, so Dwayne, you're gonna put your past in the same box as your tears, empty dreams, and broken promises? Oh, I'm sorry, that box is full.
Yeah, box of tears. Told you, he's a funny guy.
Yeah. Speaking of funny, I got this riddle. Okay. All right, check it out. Where have you been for the past 30 years?
That's okay, Flex, all right? We've already covered that. We're just happy to be back in each other's lives. Right, Pop?
Right, son.
Ooh, I'm gonna get some more photo books.
He's something else, isn't he?
Yes, he is. And I don't want to see him hurt again. So if you're playing some kind of game with him, you need to leave sooner rather than later.
Some might call me a player, but I'm not playing a game now. I missed my boy.
Hey, look. I found some old photos of you and Mom. Look at you two.
That's not me.
Oh, what about this? Oh, there you are.
That's not me either.
What about this picture of you and Mom in the hot tub?
Yeah, now that's me.
I knew it. I knew that one was you. Man, I can't wait to dig into this pre-packaged stuffing.
Dwayne Bear, how about sticking to some white meat and some green vegetables? Keep my boy strong and healthy.
All these years, I've longed for the firm yet tender hand of guidance from a man that Mama didn't meet at the racetrack, and now I have it. Maybe later you give me a whooping.
That's so touching.
Yeah, you do love touching, don't you?
Yeah, I just think it's really nice to see a father and son show affection. Too often men are afraid to show their true emotions. I think we'd all be better off if they did.
Oh, that's so sweet. Oh, he disgusts me.
Okay, everybody, before we dive in, let's join hands and go around the table saying what we're thankful for.
I'm thankful that I can eat Thanksgiving dinner without choking on incense smoke.
I'm thankful Mom finally started dating again and is having Thanksgiving at her boyfriend's house. Okay, halfway house.
I'm thankful that I'm not government cheese. You know, something cheap and very easy to get a piece of.
I'm thankful for my family and my friends and that my best friend has finally found his father, who I'm keeping this eye on at all times.
I'm thankful to have such a wonderful, loving, and healthy son with two kidneys, since I'll be needing one of them next.
I'm thankful that my fantastic daddy came back and that he needs my kidney.
What?
What? My kidney? You want my kidney? Why don't you go on and carve my heart out, too? Go on.
Dwayne, I don't see what the big deal is. All I want is a little kidney.
I knew I was right about you. I want my thankfulness back.
Son, it's not what you think.
But you know what I think? You didn't come back because you missed me. All you wanted were my kidneys. Well, we're going. Come on, fellas. Let's go.
I better go talk to him.
No, I will. I know him better. Dwayne, what are you doing?
Man, I need a drink. I mean, something to wash away the pain. Man, some hard liquor to put some hair on my chest and get rid of the hairs on my back. Cooking sherry.
I'm sorry, man. After all these years, you deserve better.
Flex, do you know what it's like to grow up without a father? I mean, not to have someone to teach you how to throw a curveball or how to talk to girls. Someone to tell you that when you shave, the blade goes up and down and not side to side.
Ooh, yeah, who could ever forget Bloody Monday?
Man, you've been more of a father to me than that, man. You were there for all my birthdays. You taught me how to drive. Taught me how to whistle, how to skip rocks. You even took me down to the fishing hole.
I think that was Andy Griffith, man.
Yeah, well, at least you were there to watch it with me. Man, I'd give you a kidney before I gave one to him. I even give one to Andy Griffith.
I get it, Dwayne. Look, I'm just as shocked as you are. What if his life depends on it? Maybe you should hear your father out before you make any decisions.
Nope. Made my mind up. My kidney stays with me.
All right, look, you my boy. And if that's your decision, now I got your back.
And if he tries to get all urban legend and take a kidney, this is gonna ruin it for him.
Dwayne, alcohol messes up your liver, not your kidneys.
Well, see, if I had a daddy, maybe I'd know that.
Flex, what do you want me to do during the show thingy?
Leave the show thingies to me. You just chime in when I cue you.
Stop it. I'm not that kind of girl without dinner and drinks.
Please, somebody wake me from this nightmare.
I'm going to air in 10 seconds, boys and girls. And 5, 4, 3.
What's up, Baltimore? This is Flex Washington with the Flex Files. Today in sports... Right. I'd like to introduce to you my new side, this is Holly, y'all.
Hi, Baltimore. I am so happy.
Now for sports. Baltimore's very own Jamal Lewis set a new rushing record against the Cleveland Browns. The question is Jamal Lewis the best running back in the game?
He's not the cutest.
I'm sorry, Holly.
Well, I'm saying he can run it all, but he isn't that cute.
Well, when it comes to Smash Mouth football, looks aren't everything. I asked Ricky Williams what he thought.
Now, Ricky Williams is a cutie pie.
Nobody cares about cuteness.
My girlfriend, Susan Watanabe, cares. She says he's got a cute butt, tight, like the conga drum. You know the conga, right, Flex?
What does that have to do with anything?
Everybody, let's conga!
Management just called from upstairs, Flex.
They love her. For you to get left behind. All right. Last night, I had an epiphany. Whatever that is. Anyway, I give you trousers created by Spirit, presenting trousers. Like sneakers.
You know what? Those aren't bad. I like them.
Oh, yeah, of course you would. Pants that come with laces, easy to get them off.
You know what, Brianna? You've been making these digs at me the last few days. If you have something you want to say to me, just say it.
I don't know what you're talking about, Arnaz.
Okay, this is driving me crazy. Arnaz, she wants to know who you've been messing around with.
Spirit, how could you say that? I told you that in confidence. So, Arnaz, who's a girl with no standards?
Dwayne!
What are you doing here?
I'm trying to talk to Dwayne, but he doesn't even want to talk to his own daddy.
Yeah, with all due respect, Mr. Knox, you may be Dwayne's father, but you're not his daddy.
With all due respect, Flex, why don't you mind your own business?
Dwayne is my business, and he's been my business for the past 30 years. You don't even know what his favorite cereal is, or what he's allergic to, or what movies make him cry. Any man can be a father, but to be a daddy, you got to know your own kid.
Who are you to judge me? How you gonna tell me what kind of daddy I am?
You're right. Flex can't tell you what kind of daddy you are, but I can tell you what kind of daddy you aren't. You're not the kind of daddy who takes his son to the hospital after he breaks his arm. You're not the kind of daddy who holds his child after they have a bad dream.
And he had a lot of those. Mm-hmm.
And you're definitely not the kind of daddy who comes back into his son's life because he loves him.
I don't blame you, Dwayne. Who am I to think that I could show up after 30 years and expect you to forgive me? Welcome me with open arms. Give me a vital organ. It was nice meeting you, son.
Look, I know I've been hard on him, but he is your father. I mean, maybe he's telling the truth.
My favorite cereal is Crunch Berries. I'm allergic to peanuts. And any movie where Nicole Kidman dies makes me cry.
Son, I may have had selfish reasons for leaving you and your mom, but my reason for coming back to find you is love. The kidney just gave me an excuse.
So you really don't need a kidney?
Oh, yeah, I need a kidney. But I need you more.
I'll leave you alone with your daddy.
All I ever wanted was to get to know you, maybe find out more about who I am.
You are Dwayne Odell Knox, my son. Your grandmother named you Dwayne. You've got her eyes and her facial hair.
Oh, yeah. Did hers growing uneven, too?
Flex, we've gotten more calls on this afternoon's Flex Files than ever.
Oh, I knew my fans would hate her. Is she fired?
Sorry, the fans love her. That bimbo is not going anywhere. Oh, Holly, hi, sweetie. Don't patronize me, sweetie. Listen, we need to renegotiate my contract, and here's how it's gonna go down. I want you to lock me in for 2 years with a third-year option, and forget about the no-compete clause. I am not some neophyte who can be constrained by the verisimilitude of an ironclad contract.
Holly, you're not dumb. You're not an idiot. You're smart.
Don't insult me. I'm brilliant. I have a master's in journalism from Columbia. There's a Mensa calendar where I'm every stinking month. But do people want the smart chick? No, they want the bimbo. So I dumbed it down like a California governor. Now, we have 20 minutes before Airflex, and you might want to stretch. We're doing the limbo tonight.
The Flex Files is my show. We're not doing the limbo. Aaron Brooks passed for over 300 yards this week, leading the Saints to a 24-10 victory. By the end of the game, his arm was as limp as a piece of macaroni.